Omma jnana dimarandasya jnanjana shalakaya chaksurun militanyena tasmai shri gurave namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shremati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavari Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading Srimad Bhagavatam. This is Canto 6. We're on Canto 6, and we're hearing about how Daksha curses Narada Muni.
我们学习的是圣典博伽瓦坛，这里学到的是达克沙，他是如何诅咒纳尔达穆尼的。
So Narada Muni had delivered.
Sorry, Sarasvati
Mataji, 请您静一下音，可以吗？
好的。
还有幸运国马太吉，好。 好, okay, good.
So Prajapati Daksha had delivered the sons of Narada Muni had delivered the sons of Prajapati Daksha. He did encourage them not to go home and not to enter family life.
Narada Muni 拯救了这个 Daksha 的一批儿子，希望他们不要进入到家居生活，不要回家。
So Prajapati Daksha was very upset that his sons did not come back home.
Prajapati Daksha 非常的悲伤沮丧，因为他的儿子不能回家了。
And he blamed Narada Muni for encouraging them.
他责怪Narada Muni 去鼓励他的儿子这么去做。
So Daksha was telling Narada Muni, he said, although I'm in Grihastha life, he said, I am a saintly person.
Daksha 跟 Narada Muni 说：“虽然我是一个居士，但是我是一个圣洁的人，我是一个圣人。”So
he said, "You showed my sons, you told my sons to take the path of renunciation."
你告诉我的儿子们要去进入到弃绝阶层。So
you have not been fair to me.
因此，fair to me.
Fair, you've not been fair. 你不平等。 You do it well.
你对我不公平。不公平,
okay. So, in this, Lord Chaitanya, you have to tell people to mute. You have to tell them to mute.
Okay, okay. 请大家静一下音，萨提玛的静，您录一下音，然后让大家静一下音，谢谢。 Okay, good day. We can.
稍等，我静一下音。好 ，Good day 和
Subiroy Prabhu，
请你们重新开一下麦，现在可以了。Good
day， you should open your microphone。
I should open my microphone. Okay.
Okay, okay.
All right, so... So in the Vedic culture, whatever ashram one is in, he's understood to be a saintly person. It's not that saintly persons are all sannyasis, but one may be in any ashram, it can be a saintly person.
在伟大的文化中，不，任何的这个阶层，他都有可能成为一个圣人，不一定是萨尼亚西，他才一定是一个圣人。任何的阶层，他都可以被提升到一个圣人。
And Prajapati Daksha, he was a saintly person. He done a lot of austerities.
Prajapati Daksha, 他曾经是一个圣人，因为他做了很多的苦行的活动。
And Lord Vishnu had appeared to Prajapati Daksha, and he had spoke to him.
主维斯努亲自显现在他面前，而且跟他说话。
But Daksha had a fault. He had one defect that he had a tendency to find fault with people.
但是 Daksha 有一个问题，就是他喜欢给别人挑毛病。
And he was wrong to criticize Narada Muni.
他不应该去责怪 Narada Muni.
Narada Muni.Certainly did not help the plans of Daksha.
Narada Muni 虽然没有帮助 Daksha, 没有帮助他的计划。
Because Daksha wanted to train his sons to become family men.
因为 Daksha 希望他的儿子能够被训练成为居士阶层。
And he sent them to do austerities before they became.In family life.
因此，在他们进入到家居生活之前，我让他们去做一些苦行。
But Narada Muni instead encouraged them to become Vaishnavas in the renounced order.
但是 Narada Muni 不仅没有违背了这个旨意，让他们进入到弃绝的这个情况之中。
Narada Muni encouraged them to go back home, back to God.
Narada Muni 希望他们能够回归家园，回归守身。
But Prajapati Daksha did not appreciate Narada Muni doing this.
但是 Prajapati Daksha 并不欣赏 Narada Muni 所做的这一点。
So Daksha, he was very angry at Narada Muni, and he said, Narada Muni is not a saintly person.
所以Daksha 对 Narada Muni 非常生气，他说 Narada Muni 你不是一个萨度，不是一个圣人。
So sannyasi, one who is a sannyasi, his duty is to beg from people to go to the homes of grihasthas and to give them spiritual knowledge.
一个 sannyasi 的职责，他是向居士去乞讨，然后给予他们灵性的知识。
But somebody who is a grihastha, they cannot do that. They cannot go begging.
但是作为居士，他们不能这么去乞讨。
Grihasthas, they have to earn their money according to the different ashrams.
居士阶层根据他们所处在的ashram, 他们去谋生。
Just like a brahmana grihastha,He can earn money by teaching people. It can teach them the knowledge of spiritual life.
就像一位婆罗门居士，他可以教人们一些知识来维系自己的生活。
And he can teach them how to worship the Supreme Lord.
他可以教别人如何从事神像崇拜，如何崇拜至尊主。
So, the brahmana, he can do deity worship, and they can accept prasadam, whatever people offer to the deity.
婆罗门可以崇拜神像，他也可以把人们供奉给神像的任何东西接受为 prasadam.
And the brahmana can also, he can accept charity. He can accept
charity. 婆罗门也可
Yeah.Not for, he can accept charity, not just for his maintenance, but for the worship of the deity.
婆罗门可以接受布施，他接受的这个布施不是为了他自己的维系他自己的生活，而是为了用于崇拜神像。
So a real Brahman, he won't keep anything for the future. He'll just use whatever he has.
一个婆罗门不会囤积任何的东西为将来所用，他就是用于现在。
And the Kshatriya, he will collect taxes from the people.
Chadidi 阶层他们可以向人们收税。
And they have to protect the people also.
他们也必须保护人们。
And they should make sure people follow the laws.
他也得保证这些人们他们在遵守着法律。
And the Vaishya, he will earn his money through agriculture and by protecting the cows.
Vaishya, 他以务农为生，务农和保护母牛。
And the Sudras, they earn their livelihood, they earn their food and their living maintenance by serving the other people.
Sudra 阶层他以服务其他三个较高阶层的人为生计。
So only the Brahmanas can take sannyas. You have to be a Brahmana in order to take sannyas.
只有婆罗门才可能成为 sannyasi.
So sannyasis and brahmacharis, sannyasis and brahmacharis, they can beg, but grihasthas should not.
Sannyasi 和这些真守生们他们可以乞讨，但是其他的阶层他们不能这么做。
So Narada Muni was a brahmachari, so he could beg, and he had made sannyasis, he'd made Daksha's sons into sannyasis.
Narada Muni 是真守生，他可以乞讨，而且他把Daksha 的儿子也变成了 sannyasi.
So Daksha, he said that Narada Muni did a great mistake, that that Daksha's sons were not experienced, they were not ready to take sannyas.
Daksha 认为 Narada Muni 犯了一个错误，因为他觉得他自己的儿子们不够那么有经验，不应该去成为 sannyasi.
He said that Narada Muni should not have encouraged these young boys. They were just like young boys. Narada Muni should not have shown them the renounced order, should not have encouraged them.
Daksha 认为自己的儿子们都非常的年轻，然而的目的不应该鼓励他们这么去做。
So sometimes a person is a, you know, he's a good devotee, but he's not understood by people in family life. Grihasthas, sometimes they cannot understand when a saintly person will instruct young men.To become devotees and to become Krishna conscious.
有些时候，虽然人们是一个好奉献者，但是他并不能理解圣人指导这些年轻的孩子们成为 Krishna 知觉的奉献者，并不能指导，并不能理解这些圣人为什么要这么去做。
People in family life, they think that unless you go through family life.Then you cannot enter into the renounced order of life. That first you should be in family life, and then you can renounce life.
通常人们这些居士们认为，除非一个人进入到居士生活，否则他不能正确的进入到弃绝阶层的这些生活。
But if you go to the renounced life without first going through grihastha life, it's not good.
如果你没有进入到居士生活，就直接进入到弃绝阶层的生活，这不是很好。
The parents of the devotee, they become upset. They think, no, my son, you should first of all be in family life, and then later on, in old age, you can renounce.
这些孩子的父母，他就会非常的不高兴。他觉得他的孩子应该先进入到居士生活，在年老的时候再去进入到弃绝阶层的生活。
So Prabhupada said, some people they're angry at our Krishna conscious movement because Prabhupada encourages them to renounce.
圣帕帕的说，有一些人对我们的 Krishna 知觉运动也非常的生气，因为我们教导人们也进入到弃绝之途。
But Prabhupada explains, we don't stop people from going into family life. But even in grihastha life, they also have to be renounced.
圣帕帕德说，我们首先并没有阻止人们进入到居士生活，另外，即便一个人进入到居士生活，他也应该变得弃绝。
Even a grihastha have to give up the bad habits.
即便一个居士也应该摒弃许多不良的坏习惯。
Just like we don't allow no meat, we don't allow intoxication, illicit sex, or gambling. So parents wonder, there's so many things you cannot do. What's the point of life?
就像我们不主张吃鱼肉蛋，不让别人过非法性生活，也不赌博，也不吸食麻醉品。那父母就看到这样的情况就觉得奇怪了，有这么多禁止的行为，那么一个人他的生活还有什么用处呢？
Especially in Western countries, people cannot live without these things.
尤其在西方国家，人们无法，就是说没有这四种活动的话，他们无法生活。
So just like Prajapati Daksha did not like Narada Muni,Many people don't like our movement, Hare Krishna movement.
就像 Prajapati Daksha, 他并不喜欢 Narada Muni. 同样的，有很多人也不喜欢我们的这个运动。
So although some parents may be angry at us, we have to go on. We can't. We have to do our duty. It's the same as Narada Muni.
但尽管如此。即便有很多父母会对我们非常生气，我们还是要毫不犹豫地履行我们的职责，就像达尔的穆里这样。
Especially people in family life and household life, they wonder how is it ever possible to give up all the sense gratification which is there in grihastha life.
在居士生活的人就感觉到奇怪。一个人他怎么能够放弃居士生活中这么多的感官享乐呢？
How can they just become renounced and join Hare Krishna movement?
他怎么就可以放弃这么多的感官享乐，变得弃绝，然后加入到 Hare Krishna 的运动之中呢？
So these people, they don't understand that family life is a concession for sense gratification.But it must be regulated according to Vedic scripture.
这些人他们应该理解家居生活的这些感官享乐应该受到规范，虽然是可以的，但是应该受到规范。
And in the Vedic culture, by the time one gets to 50, one has to give up household life.
在伟达文明之中，一个人到了五十岁就应该放弃家居生活，居士生活。
They have to retire and they have to enter into renunciation.
他们应该退休，进入到弃绝生活。
But we see people today, they get into family life, they want to stay there forever, they never want to leave it.
但是我们今天发现很多人进入到居士生活就想一辈子在这个里面，他不想离开。
So that's why they're suffering. They're so attached to their families and their sense gratification.
这就是他们受苦的原因，他们太依附于这种居士家庭生活，太依附于感官享乐。
So we encourage all the young people better join Hare Krishna movement immediately. Get away from that.
我们鼓励所有的这些年轻人立即加入到 Krishna 之觉运动，离开那种情况。
So Prajapati Daksha, he said to Narada Muni, he said, my sons, they had not paid back their debt. They had three debts. They had not settled up their debts.
Prajapati Daksha 说，我的儿子们根本没有摆脱他们的三个债务。
They forgot about their duty, their obligation to pay their debts.
他们没有考虑到他们的职责，他们的债务，他们忘记了这一点。
So the Daksha tells Narada Muni that you stop them from making progress towards a good life in this world.
Prajapati 跟 Narada Muni 说，你阻止了他们在这个世界，这个正确的好的进程。
Because they didn't pay back their debts. They have debts to the saintly persons, debts to the demigods, and debts to their own father.
他们有三个债务，第一个债务是亏欠圣人，第二个是亏欠半圣人，第三个是亏欠他们父亲的这个债务。
So as soon as somebody takes birth, as soon as a brahmana takes birth, he has three kinds of debts. The same, the debt to the saintly persons, debts to the demigods, and debts to his father.
Brahmana 一旦出生就得承担三种债务，亏欠伟大圣人的债，亏欠半圣人的债务，以及亏欠他父亲的债务。
So the son of a brahmana, he must practice brahmachari for some time to pay his debt to the saintly persons.
Brahmana 的儿子们必须履行遵守生活一段时间，去清还他亏欠圣人的这些债务。
And then he has to do ritualistic ceremonies to pay his debts to the demigods.
他必须通过履行祭祀来清偿他亏欠半神的债务。
And to pay his debt to his father,He has to beget some children.
他必须繁衍后代来清偿他亏欠他父亲的债务。
So Prajapati Daksha, he is saying that although renounced order is recommended for liberation, you cannot get liberation unless you first pay your debts.
Prajapati Daksha 说，虽然气绝阶层。受到推荐，他可以获得解脱，但是除非一个人完成他的债务，否则不能获得解脱。
So Narada Muni should not have took them into the renounced order of life.
因此 ，Narada Muni 不应该让他们脱离这三种债务。
So this means that Daksha he didn't know that the scriptures say.That anybody who surrenders to Krishna is freed of all debts.
事实上，大 Prajapati Daksha 他并不知道经典的论断是，当一个人能够臣服 Krishna 的话，他摆脱了所有的债务。
We could say everybody has a debt to the demigods, to the living entities, and to his family, and to the Pitas, and so on. We could say everybody has debts. Everybody.But if one surrenders to Krishna, then he's freed of all his debts.
我们说每一个人其实都对每一个人都对半神人普通生物家族祖先等等都负有债务。但是如果这个人能够全然的臣服 Krishna 的话，他免于所有的这些债务。
So if somebody renounces the material world for the sake of Krishna, he's free of all of his debts.
一个人，为了 Krishna 弃绝这个世界，他能够免于所有的债务。
This is the decision of the scriptures.
这是经典的论断。
So Narada Muni was right in instructing the sons of Daksha to renounce the material world.
因此 ，Narada Muni 教导 Daksha 的儿子去弃绝这个物质世界，事实上是正确的。
Narada Muni told him immediately do it and take shelter of Krishna.
Narada Muni 跟他们说，立即就去做这件事情，去弃绝，然后脱避于 Krishna.
But Daksha, he didn't understand the real mood of Narada Muni and the service which Narada Muni was doing.
但是 Daksha 他并不能理解 Narada Muni， 并不能理解 Narada Muni 所做的巨大的服务。
So Daksha, he said to Narada Muni, you are sinful, and you're not a saintly person.
所以 Daksha 才说 Narada Muni, 你是一个罪恶的，你不是一个圣洁的人。
But Narada Muni is a Vaishnava, he's a devotee, he tolerates all these things, he doesn't get disturbed.
但是 Narada Muni 他是一位伟大的奉献者和圣人，他能够容忍 Prajapati Daksha 所说的这一切。
He just did his duty as a devotee and he brought the sons of Daksha out of material life and helped them to go back home back to Godhead.
他只是履行他作为一名奉献者的职责，拯救 Prajapati Daksha 的儿子们，使他们能够回归家园，回归守神。
So Prajapati Daksha is still angry at Narada Muni and he said, you committed violence against other people, other living entities, and yet you claim to be an associate of Lord Vishnu.
Prajapati Daksha 继续非常生气地说道，你竟然你向其他的这些生物体施暴，而且还竟然声称自己是主威士努的同游。
You bring a bad name to Krishna.
你给 Krishna 带来了很不好的名誉。
You want to make people renounce. You make these innocent boys into renunciates, into sannyasis. So you should be ashamed of yourself.
你毫无必要的把这些天真的孩子们变得那么的气绝。你应该为你的行为感觉到羞耻。
You have no compassion. You didn't care about other people.
你没有同情心，你也不关心其他人。
How can you ever travel with the personal associates of Lord Krishna?
你怎么能和至尊主亲生的同游们一起云游呢？
So, even today, people think like Daksha. Many people in the world, they think like Daksha. When young boys become devotees, their fathers get very angry.
今天还有很多人的心态也就像这样，像 Daksha 这样，当他们的这些年轻孩子们加入到 Krishna 之觉运动，他们的父母就会非常的生气。
Yeah, their parents, they say that you're not allowing our children to enjoy the material world. You should let them enjoy eating, drinking, and making merry, having a good time.
你不让我的这些孩子们去吃喝玩乐，你不让他们进入到家居生活，不让他们结婚。
The karmis, they always think that one should enjoy life in the material world.
这些功利性主义者，他们认为人就应该在这个物质世界享受他的一生。
And at the same time, do some pious activities so that you can go to the higher planets.
同时还做一些虔诚的活动，这样就可以在将来提升到高等的星宿。
And then they can enjoy in the next life.
这样他们在下一生又可以继续享受。
But a bhakti yogi, a yogi and a bhakti yogi in particular, he doesn't think like that.
但是一个瑜伽师，尤其是奉爱瑜伽师，他绝对不会这样去想。
The bhakti yogi, he doesn't want to go to the higher planets just to enjoy a long life.
奉爱瑜伽师绝对不想提升到高等的星宿，有较长的寿命。
For a devotee, even merging into the Brahman is like hell for him.
对于一个奉献者来说，即便是融入到 Brahman 凡之中，也是对他们来说像地狱一样。
And life in the heavenly planets with the demigods is just, it has no real existence. It's just like a dream for devotees. It has no purpose.
对于奉献者来说，即便是在高等星宿的这些半神天堂星球中的这些生活，对于他们来说其实是一种幻象，没有毫无任何意义。
So the pure devotees,They're not interested in yoga cities, they don't want yoga powers, and they don't want to travel to the higher planets either.
对于纯粹的奉献者来说，他们对瑜伽的完美，对瑜伽的这个玄秘，他们并不感兴趣，他们也不想旅行，在这个高等的星系中去旅行。
And they don't want to merge with the Brahman.
他们也不想与 Brahman 融为一体。
He just wants to give service to Krishna.
他只想给主 Krishna 做一些服务。
So Daksha, because he's a karmi, he could not understand the service of Narada Muni.
Daksha, 他是一名功利性活动者，他并不理解 Narada Muni.
Daksha had 11,000 sons, and Narada Muni had delivered all of them and got them all to renounce the material world.
Daksha 有一万一千个儿子。而那儿的穆里全部把他的这一万一千个儿子给拯救了。
But Daksha thinks Narada Muni is sinful, and he said Narada Muni that he's brought a bad name to Krishna.
然而，Daksha 认为那儿的穆里却是罪恶的，而且给主 Krishna 带来了不好的名声。
So even though Narada Muni is an associate of Krishna.Daksha is saying Narada is an offender to Krishna.
所以即便 Narada Muni 是主的一位同游 Daksha 却认为却指责 Narada Muni 是主的冒犯者。
So Daksha said, all the devotees of Krishna, except for you, are very kind to the conditioned souls.
Daksha 说除了你之外的所有的奉献者对这些受条件限制的灵魂都很仁慈。
The devotees of Krishna are all, they want to benefit others.
主的奉献者总是想希望别人能够受。
And you wear the dress, Daksha says to Narada Muni, you wear the dress like a devotee, but you create enemies with people.
却创造了这个敌意。
Or you make enemies between people who are friends, you make them enemies.
你与你的敌人们为敌，或者说你破坏了这种友谊，你在朋友之间制造了敌意。
At the same time, you pretend to be a devotee, and you're doing all these terrible things.
你一边假装成为一个奉献者，一边又做着这些很不好的事情。
You should be ashamed of yourself, Daksha tells Narada Muni.
你应该为此的行为感觉到羞耻 ，Daksha 对 Narada Muni 说，你应该为你的行为感觉到羞耻。
So people in the disciplic succession coming from Narada Muni, they're often criticized in this way.
处在Narada Muni 这个使徒传系的这些人，Sorry, Gurudev.
In the line of Narada Muni, the disciplic succession, people often criticize the devotees in the same way Narada Muni got criticized.
人们通常去批评 Narada Muni, 处在 Narada Muni 这个师徒传系的这些奉献者，人们也经常会这样去批评在这个师徒传系的这些。
The Krishna consciousness movement is to train young men to become devotees and to go back to Godhead.
Krishna 知觉运动为了训练年轻人能够成为好的奉献者，回归守神，回归家园。
They have to follow the regulative principles.
这些年轻人得遵循规范原则。
But even in India, as well as in the Western countries, people don't appreciate this.
但是即便是在印度包括这些西方国家我们的 Krishna 知觉运动并没有受到欣赏。
We are trying to spread the Krishna consciousness movement, but these people, they're against it.
我们在传播 Krishna 知觉运动但是有一些人他们反对。
And those people who are born in Brahmana families, they don't like Krishna consciousness movement.
那些出生在婆罗门阶层的这些人，他们反对 Krishna 知觉运动。
Because in Krishna consciousness, we let anybody become a Brahmana. It doesn't matter what birth they have.
因为我们的 Krishna 知觉运动把所有的这些，无论是谁，都把他们提升到 Brahmana 这个层面，无论他们之前是什么状态。
And we train them in austerity and penances, so that they can become good Brahmanas.And give them the sacred thread.
我们训练他们，让他们做一些苦行，以便他们能够成为婆罗门，并授予他们圣贤。
So the brahmanas, the caste brahmanas, those who are brahman by birth, they don't like that.
所以那些由于出生而成为的这些 brahmana, 他们并不欣赏这一点，他们也不认可这一点。
And then in the Western countries, the parents of the young people who join our movement, they also don't like our movement.
而在西方，有一些父母对于我们，因为我们把一些年轻人变成了这些奉献者，所以这些父母对于我们的 Krishna 知觉运动也并不感到满意。
We don't want to make enemies. Our movement is not, you know, we don't like to make enemies. But somehow these people become our enemy.
我们并不想树敌，并不想与人为敌，但是不知怎地，这些人就对我们充满了敌意。
Because they're not devotees, so they cannot understand our movement.
因为他们不是奉献者，所以他们并不能理解这个运动。
But devotees have to be tolerant and merciful.
但是奉献者应该容忍并充满仁慈。
And any devotee who's doing preaching work, they have to expect that the people are not going to like what you're doing.
对于那些从事传播的这些奉献者，他们不要期望别人会喜欢他们。
But at the same time, they have to be merciful to the conditioned souls.
但同时，他们应该对受条件限制的灵魂充满仁慈。
So if we can do the duty like Narada Muni, then you'll get recognized by Krishna.
如果我们能够做 Narada Muni 这样履行 Narada Muni 类似的这些职责，我们一定能够得到 Krishna 的赏识。
Krishna said, "There's nobody more dear to me than that person who's teaching devotional service."
主 Krishna 说，对于这样的人，没有人比他对我来说更亲切。这个人就是他向别人讲述 Krishna 知觉的这个知识。
So we should keep preaching, and we shouldn't be afraid of our enemies.
因此，我们应该继续传播，而不应该对我们的敌人感觉到畏惧。
Our duty is to please Krishna by preaching.
我们的职责是通过传播使 Krishna 感到满意。
We have to just be sincere to serve Krishna and not be put off by all these enemies.
我们应该真诚地服务 Krishna, 而不要被这些敌人所阻碍。
So,
打消。
Narada Muni, he's in the line of the disciplic succession coming from Brahma.
Narada Muni 是Narada Muni 这个师徒传系是来自于 Brahma。
So sometimes the disciplic succession causes some break in the friendship, in the family relationships. It creates some bitter feelings between the family and the relatives.
有些时候因为Narada Muni 这个师徒传系的成员使友谊和家庭生活这个瓦解了。
So devotees are friendly to everyone.
但是奉献者应该很友好地对待每一个人。
But sometimes they're misunderstood and people think they're the enemies.
但是有一些误解就在中间产生了，别人认为我们就是敌人。
So to be a preacher is not an easy job. It's a difficult task. And you have to follow the rules, have to follow the orders of Krishna and not be afraid.
成为一个传播者是一件费力不讨好的事情。我们应该遵守这些原则，不要害怕，应该遵循主 Krishna 的训令。
Yeah, we shouldn't be afraid of the materialistic people.
我们不要对物质主义者有所畏惧。
Because we have Krishna with us, so we don't have to fear anyone.
因为我们有 Krishna 在我们的身边，所以我们不要害怕。
So Prajapati Daksha tells Narada Muni, he said, if you think that just by getting people to renounce will make them detached from the material world, I think you're making a big mistake.
Prajapati Daksha 说，如果你认为只是唤醒别人的气绝感就能使人气绝，那么我得说你这是一个错误。
People, before they renounce, they have to have full knowledge. They have to awaken full knowledge, then they can renounce.
在人们气绝之前，他应该唤醒他全部的知识。有这个知识之后，他们才能够气绝。
So just by changing the dress, that's not going to make them detach from the material world.
只是让他们换一件外衣，并不能让他们就这么气绝这个物质世界了。
So Prajapati Daksha is right in stating that.
事实上 Prajapati Daksha 这么说是正确的。
You don't become detached from the material world just by changing the dress.
你只是更换一个外衣，并不能使人弃绝这个物质世界。
So in the Kali Yuga, some sannyasis, they think that when they change their dress from white color to saffron, they think that they can do whatever they like.
在卡利年代的这些有一些 sannyasi， 他们认为把自己的白色衣服换成这个橙色的衣服，他们就可以为所欲为了。
So these people who think like that, although they're supposed to be sannyasis, if they think they can do whatever they like, then these are worse than the most materialistic grihamedis, the people in family life.
有这么一个概念的人，他们认为自己可以为所欲为的这样的这些 sannyasi， 他们事实上比物质主义的这些 grihamedi 更加的卑劣。
Yeah.Sannyasis, they think they're so foolish, they think they can do what they like. It's so bad, it's very bad.
一个 sannyasi 如果认为自己可以为所欲为的话，这是非常非常不好的。
So Prajapati Daksha was right to show that this was a mistake, that people should have proper knowledge before they renounce.
Prajapati 这么指出的实际上是正确的。人们在弃绝之前应该有恰当的知识。
But Prajapati Daksha, he didn't know that Narada Muni had actually given them, he trained them in renunciation.
但是 Prajapati Daksha 不知道 Narada Muni 事实上已经激发了，给予了他们这种弃绝的精神知识。
Narada Muni had given them that knowledge to enlighten them about renunciation.
Narada Muni 已经给予了他们气绝的这个知识，启迪了他们。
So people who want to renounce, they have to be enlightened. They have to have good knowledge of the scriptures.
人们想要变得气绝，他应该是得到启迪，对经典有所觉悟。
Right. So you want to go into the renounced order. You want to be like a sannyasi. You have to have full knowledge.
你如果想进入到弃绝阶层，想成为一个萨尼亚西的话，你得有完全的这个知识。
When you renounce the material world, then you have to want to achieve the perfection of life.
当你弃绝这个物质世界，那你应该想要去争达生命的完美。
So we can come to that stage very easily.By studying books like Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们可以通过学习圣典博伽瓦坛轻易地达到这个层面。
Just by developing our devotion to the Supreme Lord, Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Jnana Yati Asuvairagyam Jnanam Chayat Ahaitukam. By doing devotional service for Vasudev Krishna,then you automatically get knowledge and detachment from the material world.
通过对人格守神 Vasudeva Krishna 做奉爱服务，一个人会立即获得终极的知识，弃绝这个物质世界。
So anybody who is doing, if you're serious and do devotional service for Lord Krishna, Vasudev, then all the knowledge and the detachment will come just simply by doing devotional service.
如果一个人很认真地对主 Vasudeva Krishna 做奉爱服务，所有的知识和气诀会自动到来。
So there's no doubt we should be convinced of that.
这个是毋庸置疑的，我们应该确信这一点。
So Prajapati Daksha was accusing Narada Muni that he had not actually elevated his sons to the platform of knowledge.
Prajapati 责备 Narada 说他没有把他的儿子们提升到知识的层面。
But that's not true. He did. He'd actually brought them to the platform of knowledge.
但这并不是事实。因为 Narada Muni 已经把他的儿子提升到了知识层面。
And so Narada Muni brought them to the platform of knowledge, and then they automatically renounced the world.
Narada Muni 把他的儿子们提升到了气觉，提升到了知识的层面，之后他的儿子们自动的气觉了。
Without having that knowledge, then they couldn't be renounced.
没有这种知识，他们是无法弃绝的。
Because without that knowledge, you cannot give up the attachment to material enjoyment.
因为没有这种知识的话，他们无法放弃对物质享受的依附。
So then Daksha continues, he says, material enjoyment is the cause of all unhappiness.
Daksha 说物质享受确实是所有不快乐的原因。
But one cannot give up material enjoyment unless one has personal experience about the suffering.
但是一个人并不能摒除这种物质感官享乐，除非他亲自体验到这种享乐带来的是多么就是很大的痛苦，除非他亲自体验到这种痛苦。
So Daksha is saying, people should be allowed to stay in the material enjoyment, and at the same time, they should advance in knowledge.
一个人应该在知识的方面取得进步的同时，得到所谓的物质感官享乐。
And in this way, they will experience the misery.Of the material happiness.
就这样，他才能够体验到虚假的物质快乐的痛苦。
This material happiness is all illusion, so they'll understand that.
所有的物质快乐都是虚假的。
And then without
这样，他就能够理解。
But they won't need any help from anybody else. They will understand themselves that material enjoyment is not pleasant.
就这样的话，即便没有其他人的帮助，他也能够发现物质感官享乐是令人厌恶的。
So when people's minds are changed by others, then it's they don't become so renounced as what they do if they do it by their own personal experience.
有一些人的心意。当有一些人他的心意因别人而感觉到变化的时候，他不会，他因为他会有自己的这种感受，所以他不会那么容易因其他人的影响而让自己的心意变得那么的变化。
It's better they experience it for themselves.
最好他们自己能够亲自体验到这一切。
If somebody tries to change their mind for them.That's not so good.
如果有人去改变他们的心意，这并不好。
So Prabhupada gives an example. He says, just like a woman when she becomes pregnant. So a woman who's been pregnant, she knows the trouble, what it is to give birth to the child, how much pain and how much suffering she goes through.
圣帕巴德在这里举了个例子，就说一个妇女她怀孕之后，她能够理解生孩子是很麻烦的。
But a woman who's never given birth to a child, she cannot understand.
但是一个没有生育过的女人，他们是无法理解生孩子有多么大的麻烦。
She's never been pregnant. She never delivered a child. She doesn't know about all the pain which there is in giving birth to a child.
她既没有怀孕，也没有生过孩子，她就无法理解，无法知道这个系列的过程是多么的痛苦。
So, according to Daksha, he's saying that a woman should first become pregnant and then experience the pain of childbirth.
根据 Daksha 的哲学，一个女人首先应该怀孕，然后去体验生孩子的痛苦。
Then if she's intelligent, she'll not want to give birth again.
如果这个女人很聪明的话，她就不会再次想怀孕了。
Of course, this is not true.
当然 ，Daksha 的这套哲学并不正确。
Because the desire for sex is so strong, women become pregnant again and again.
因为性的享受是如此的强劲，致使女人想一次又一次的怀孕。
So although she suffered before.She's willing to suffer again because she wants sex so badly.
即便她之前在生孩子的时候很痛苦，但是她还是想再次怀孕，因为这个物质感官享乐非常非常的强劲。
So Daksha, he's saying that if you get one who has material enjoyment.So after he has material enjoyment, he will know about all the suffering of material world.
所以 Daksha 的哲学是，他说一个人进行了物质感官享乐之后，他就会理解物质感官享乐的所有的这些痛苦。
And then he will want to renounce.
然后他就会很自然的想要去弃绝。
But we see it's not like that. It doesn't work like that.
但是我们发现事实并不是这样的。
We see a man suffers, he suffers so much in the material life, but he never stops, he never gives up his desire to enjoy material life.
我们发现一个男人他在这个物质世界经受过巨大的痛苦，但是他仍然不会停止想要去享乐。
So unless you get the association of a devotee like Narada Muni or his servant, then it's very hard to give up the desire for material enjoyment.
因此，除非一个人能够得到像 Narada Muni 或者一位仆人或他的仆人的这种涟漪，否则他无法弃绝这种物质的感官享乐。
That's not a fact. It's not true that just because material enjoyment brings so much suffering that people will automatically want to give it up.
不是说物质感官享乐带来很多的痛苦，一个人就能够很自然而然地得到弃绝，不是这样的。
You need the blessings of a devotee like Narada Muni.
要真正的弃绝，我们得需要南尔德穆利的祝福，这样的一位奉献者的祝福。
Then you can give up the attachment for the material world.
如此才能够弃绝对物质世界的依附。
So, Prabhupada said the young people who have come to Krishna consciousness movement, they gave up the idea to enjoy the material world.
圣帕帕的说，加入 Krishna 知觉的这些男孩女孩们，他们摒弃了享受物质世界的概念。
They gave it up by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya and his devotees.
他们之所以能够放弃，是得到了主 Chaitanya 以及他仆人的仁慈。
They didn't give it up just because of they had so much practice trying to enjoy. They gave it up by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
这些人之所以能够放弃，不是通过他们的训练享受去得到放弃， 而是他们得到了主柴坦亚以及他的仆人的仁慈。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
Okay.
Are there any questions?
Yes. First question from Vivo. 冒犯圣人会有报应。Daksha 批评 Narada 居然没有什么恶报，什么原因？这是否鼓励冒犯圣人？When offends the saintly person, they have some reaction. But Daksha criticized Narada Muni. It seems he didn't get any bad reaction. What's why it happens? So it means encourage the to offend the saintly person?
Well, you have to wait and see. How do you know he didn't get any reaction? That's an assumption on your part. Well, the story's not finished yet. Daksha's just begun.
你得继续等着看。你怎么能说 Daksha 没有得到这个恶报或者说反应呢？我们这个故事并没有结束，我们得往后面继续看才能够了解。这个故事还没有结束。
Next question from 徐小元。Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev 和翻译。最近我很主动的去给新认识的很有灵气的中医大夫免费送 Prasadam 和书，送了两次。他今天说我神神秘秘、神神叨叨的，以后不会去见他了。我很难过，我的问题是，是不是奉献者太主动、热情，免费去派发菩萨的果书，会让对方觉得很容易得来的东西不珍惜？我以后应该怎样智慧的去派发菩萨的果圣名呢 ？Hare Krishna, basis to Gurudev. Recently, I give some prasadam and books to a Chinese doctor. But he thinks I'm so enthusiastic. So he thinks I'm not normal. So I will not to meet this doctor again. I feel a little upset. My question is it that the devotees are so much enthusiasm to give the prasadam and the books for free. So it makes the new people makes it feel that this is very easy to get. So they will not make it think it very important. So how can I to preach the prasadam and the books, the holy name, with intelligence?
Yes, you have to be more cautious about how you present the books and the prasadam. You have to explain to them that this is something very special and that they're very, very fortunate.
是的，你得非常小心和注意你去派发普沙丹或者这些书籍。你得解释这个东西是非常非常难得的，非常非常非常值得珍惜的。
Maybe your enthusiasm was something which he was jealous that he does not have such enthusiasm for anything he does, and he cannot understand how you have so much enthusiasm for what you're doing.
因为你太热情了，但是他没有那种热情去理解你的这种热情。
Because he doesn't do anything enthusiastically.
而且他也没有做任何非常有热情的事情。
And he never gives anything to people free. He never gives any mercy. He never gives books of knowledge. He never gives prasadam to anyone.
也就是说，他之前从来没有做过像你这样热情的事情，比如说把prasadam、把书籍很免费的派发给别人。他以前从来没有这么做过。
So when you give it to him, then he just wonders what's going on. He can't understand it. He can't relate to it. It's just something which is so new to him. He's puzzled.
所以当你这么去做呈现在他面前的时候，对于他来说他非常的新，他无法理解你做的这一切。
So you definitely have to be more careful in the future about giving people books and prasadam.
所以当然很必要的，你在未来应该非常小心，非常注意的给予别人 prasadam 和书籍。
Let them know this is something very special.
要让他们能够知道这是一些非常特别的。
Or you sell them to them. You get them to pay for the books. You get them to pay for the prasadam. Then they can understand.
或者你把这些卖给他们，你把书卖给他们，你把这个 prasadam 卖给他们，这样他们或许能够理解。
But when you give them something free, they're puzzled. Why you give me free? I never get anything free.
因为你把东西免费的给予他们的时候，他们就惊讶的，你为什么要免费的给我？我以前从来没有免费的得到这些 prasadam 和这些书籍。
So shall you and Mataji need you eat?
所以徐小媛妈的紧，你要想一想，注意一下。
You take more care how you preach to people, new people. The first these impressions they get in the beginning are very important.
你要思考一下如何向这些新人去传播，因为给别人的第一印象是非常重要的。
Okay.
Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, good day. Please accept my humble basis. How can knowledge of the philosophy of Krishna consciousness help renunciation of the material world? Hare Krishna, good day. 请接受我卑微的顶拜。这个知识 ，Krishna 知觉的哲学知识，如何能够帮助物质世界的人去弃绝？
By understanding the temporary nature of the material world, we will naturally want to be renounced from it.
通过理解这个物质世界的短暂，我们就能够很自然而然地变得弃绝。
And by understanding how much difficulty there is in the material world to get just a little bit of pleasure.
通过理解这个物质世界，我们要花那么大的努力去获得一丁点的感官享乐，我们也能够弃绝。
So much endeavor, so much effort is required to get just tiny little bits of pleasure.
要花那么大的努力，那么多的辛苦，才能得到一丁点的感官享乐。
And it's so difficult to satisfy people in the material world.
而且在物质世界要满足一个人非常非常的困难。
Nobody is satisfied. You get married, the woman can't satisfy her husband, or the husband can't satisfy the wife, and the parents can't satisfy the children, and their parents are not satisfied. Even the dog's not satisfied.
在物质世界之中，没有人是满意的。比如说，你结婚，妻子不满意丈夫，丈夫不满意妻子，孩子不满意父母，父母不满意孩子，还有，即便是那条狗，它也不会满意它的主人，都有这种情况。
And your government is not satisfied with you.
甚至政府也不会对一些老百姓满意。
Your employees, the people you work for, they're not satisfied with you.
或者你的老板对你也不满意。
So difficult to satisfy people. No matter how you give your whole life for them, you work so hard, try to please them, you can't do it.
你在这个物质世界，即便你付出那么大努力，把你的一生都献出去，你都无法满足他们。
Yeah, next question.
Okay, next question from Hari Vamsa. 在居士生活中体验到痛苦，依然会为感官享乐再次受苦。要想弃绝，依然会因为什么而再次去拥有？依然 会因为什么在群体中或者体验到的苦，依然会因感官享乐而再次受苦？要想弃绝，依然会因为什么？In the grihast life, we experience some sufferings, but we will also will continually for the enjoyment to do some to get some sufferings.If we want to get the renunciations, Hanuamsa, I count on, 我不能理解你这个问题，能不能说的简单一点？对我来说有点绕。我们现在先看下一个问题。Next question from Yogini Yashoda, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您的莲花组顶拜翻译。我昨天去给一个朋友派发博家梵歌，他翻了几页，也跟他说了价格，但是他说看不懂，不感兴趣，出的印刷字体太小。总之有很多理由拒绝我。对他是选择放弃，还是继续向他派发经典？谢谢 Guru Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. This is to your Lord's faith. Yesterday I distributed a Bhagavad Gita to my friend. Then she opened the book and she got the prize. But she said she can't understand this book and have no interest.Because this book, the title is very small. He can't see it, watch it very clearly. And she gave me other reasons to reject me. So I'm wondering whether should I continue to distribute the books to her or I should give up. Thank you.
Well, I think maybe you picked the wrong book to give her.Maybe you should have started her with a small book.
我认为你或许给了她一本错误的书，你或许可以给她一本小的书给她看一看。
Even better, if they hear the classes, if they hear some discussion of devotees, then they can gradually develop an interest in the knowledge.
或者说她去听一节课，能够和奉献者探讨一下，聊一学，聊一聊，这样他就能够发展出一些知识。
But if they never had the knowledge before, they didn't know what Bhagavad Gita was about, and you come and give them the Bhagavad Gita, it's going to be difficult for them. They don't know anything about it, and you come up to them with this book, Bhagavad Gita, they've not never heard of it before, they don't know anything about the subject, it'll be very hard for them, yeah.
如果他们以前从来没有听过类似的主题或相关的主题，而你呈现的这个博家梵歌给他，对于他们来说就会很困难。
So you did not preach very well. You did not do your preaching work very carefully. You have to be more careful how you approach people.
因此你这个传播的工作没有做好，你应该再小心一点，应该思考一下如何能够让它做得更好。
You have to think what would be the right book, what would be a good book, and you have to gradually cultivate their interest in the knowledge.
你应该思考到底什么书对于他们来说是好的，什么是适合他们的，你应该培养，逐渐地培养他们灵性的这个知识。
They should be begging to get the book. Oh, I want some, I've been trying to get to this book for so long. You just tell them, no, no, we don't have any copies. No, it's very hard to get. No, you can't get, no, there's only a few copies. We're sure we can't give you. You know, you want to make it really difficult for them to get. But if you give it to them very easily, then they don't want it.
你应该让他们感受到他们要非常渴求这本书。哦，这本书只有几本呢，我没法给你，现在只有几本呢。
Well, you have to make it more valuable to people. You have to,
你应该让这些书显得更有价值。
You have to increase their desire to want to read this book.
你应该增加他们想得到这本书的渴望。
If you make it just too easy for them, then they don't think anything, they don't value it.
如果你让他们觉得这本书非常容易得到，他们并不会重视它。
They should be begging to get that book.
他们应该渴求这本书，渴求要得到这本书。
So you have to gradually bring these people along.
你应该逐渐地把这些人提升到这个层面。
You bring, make it too easy for them. They'll just say, oh, they're just, he's just trying to give me, bring me into something he believes in. They won't take it. They won't go for it. You make it, you have to make it more attractive to them.
你应该让这些书变得更有吸引力。如果让他们更有，如果让他们觉得这个东西很简单，很容易就得到的话，那个那个不会特别好，让他们更要让这些事情变得更有吸引力。
Yes. Any other question?
Okay. Next question from Vaishnava Vani. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. My humble obeisance. Narada Muni is a pure devotee. Is it right that pure devotees never make any mistake? So can I think that?Daksha didn't understand the great position of Narada Muni, and he can never make mistake because Daksha was also in a great position. He understand underestimated Narada Muni. Thank you for the wonderful class. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 我卑微的顶拜。Narada Muni 是一个纯粹的奉献者。是不是说一个纯粹的奉献者从来就不犯任何的错误呢？我们能不能说 Daksha 他并不理解 Narada Muni 的伟大的位置，因为他，而且他从不犯错误，所以 Daksha， 而且因为 Daksha 也处在一个很高，而且 Daksha 也处在一个很高的位置上，他误解了 Narada Muni。
Yes, you're exactly right.Vaishnavi Vani Mataji, you're correct that Daksha underestimated Narada Muni.
是的，你说的是对的。Daksha 他误解了 Narada Muni.
Daksha was applying his material thinking to the transcendental dealings of Narada Muni.
Oh.Sorry, Gurudev, 我这里翻译错了。这个 Daksha 他低估了 Narada Muni。Gurudev, can you say it again?
Yes. So,
okay, sorry.
Daksha was thinking in terms of the material body and material relationships, but Narada Muni is on the transcendental platform.
Daksha 想的是躯体的这个层面以及躯体的这种关系，但是 Narada Muni 他处在超然的层面上。
So because Daksha was on the material platform, he couldn't understand the thinking of Narada Muni.
Daksha 处在物质的层面上，他无法理解 Narada Muni.
But Prabhupada was explaining that.This is the problem, similarly with our movement, that people don't understand our movement.
所以圣帕帕德在这里也说了同样的事情，有很多人也无法理解我们的运动，这是一个问题。
They criticize devotees.
他们批评奉献者。
And they criticize Prabhupada taking people away from their families.
他们批评圣帕帕德把他们的人脱离了家庭。
But they don't understand that this is for a higher purpose, for the service of Krishna.
他们不理解，这是为了一个更高的目标，是为了 Krishna.
So Daksha is just in the bodily platform. He's only thinking materially.
Daksha 他只处在躯体的层面，他思考的是物质的。
He cannot understand.The activities of a devotee.
他无法理解一个奉献者的行为活动。
There's a big difference. They're both, you know, Daksha is also a saintly person, but he's not on the level of Narada Muni.
Daksha 也在一个圣人的层面上，但是他并没他并不是和 Narada Muni 处在同一个层面上。
Daksha also is renounced, and he's also doing service for the Supreme Lord.
Daksha 也很气绝，他也为至尊主做了很多的服务。
But his service is dealing with the material world. Narada Muni's service is taking people back to Godhead.
但是 Daksha 的服务，他的活动是为了这个物质世界，而 Narada Muni 是为了把人们从物质世界带回守神的。
So Daksha's service is important. It's nice, but it's not. To stop Narada Muni from doing what Narada Muni is doing.
Daksha 的工作是正确的，也是很好的，但是他不应该去阻止 Narada Muni 所做的事情。
Narada Muni's service is the highest.
Narada Muni 的服务是最高的。
And Prabhupada quoted from the Bhagavad Gita, there's no one more dear to me than one who's preaching devotional service.
Narada Muni, 圣帕帕德从博迦梵歌中引述了一个事件，没有人比他来说对我来说更亲切。他是一个奉献者，他向人传播。
So we have to be willing to accept that sometimes people will criticize us and they won't like us.
因此我们有些时候得去接受这样的情况，有些人他并不接受我们，而且还批评我们。
They'll say, why you have to do this? Why you have to do this? This is no good.
你为什么要做这些东西都是不好的。
Why you have to take people away from their home, from their family?
你为什么要把这些人从他们的家里面带走，从他们的家庭之中、生活之中带走
？But the idea is to take them home to the real family, to the family in the spiritual world.
但是这个真实的情况是，我们是把他们带到一个真正的家庭，带回灵性的世界。
This material world, this is not a real family.
这个物质世界不是一个真正的家庭。
It's very temporary.
非常的短暂。
Okay.
Okay. This question from Hari Vamsa. 在居士生活中体验到痛苦，依然会为了感官享乐再次受苦，想要弃绝，也会因感官享乐再次渴求而想要弃绝，也会因感官享乐而再次渴求去拥有物质财富吗？所以关键的是有一颗享受物质世界的心愿，对吗？再去依然要想要弃绝，也会想要弃绝，也会因为感官享乐而再次渴求去拥有物质世界物质财富，想要。Very hard to. In the Grihastha life, we experience the sufferings, but we still want to get some enjoyment, then get sufferings. If we want some renunciations, can I? It's still because of the material enjoyment, and still want to get more material opulence. Good day, can you understand?
No. I didn't get this last part. Want to get material opulence?
If I want to get renunciation,
But at the same time, you want material opulence?
Yes.
Well, these are contrary. These go against each other, right?
Yes. So I think I get some point. If in one side, he want to get some renunciations, so I will also still for some material enjoyment and again to ask some material opulence.
Yes, this is like Bhoga Tyaga. We say Bhoga Tyaga, it means we want enjoyment, then we want to renounce. And then after we renounce for some time, then we want enjoyment again. And then we enjoy, and then after some time, then we tire of it, then we want to renounce again. So we go back and forward. Enjoyment and renunciation. Enjoyment and renunciation. That is the material world. It's like that.
这个情况被称为Bogatiaga, 就是我们想要一点气绝,然后又想要感官享乐,感官享乐以后又气绝,气绝之后又感官享乐, 就是不断这种,有一种循环的, 有一种往复的这种情况在里面。
So it's a very temporary condition. It means you're never satisfied.
这是一种很短暂的处境,你在这种处境之中,你永远不会得到真正的满足。
You're on the platform of the mind. One day the mind wants to renounce, the next day the mind wants to enjoy.
事实上你处在这种心意的概念之中,有一天你想弃绝,有一天你又想感官享乐。
And so this goes on eternally, throughout the life, birth after birth.
其实这个事情永恒的在发生着,一生复一生的都在发生着,一世复一世的在发生着。
We have to transcend the mind, we have to come to the higher platform, transcendental consciousness.
我们得超越这个心意,来到超然的这个层面上,超越心意,来到超然的层面上。
We have to understand that neither enjoyment nor renunciation is the actual position of transcendent. That's not the spiritual platform, that's a material platform.
我们要理解的是,无论是气绝还是感官享乐,都是物质的层面,它都不是超人的层面。
So we have to develop the attachment to Krishna, and want to please Krishna and serve Krishna.
因此,我们要发展的是对Krishna的依附,发展出对Krishna的服务,以及对Krishna的依附。
So devotional service means like that. Devotional service means we simply think what does Krishna want, not what do I want.
因此奉献服务的含义和精要是我们在想 Krishna 需要的是什么,而不是想我需要什么。
We don't know what we want. One day you want enjoyment, and the next day you want to renounce, and you go back and forth.
我们根本就不知道我们自己要什么,我们今天想要气绝,明天要想感官行乐,过两天又想要气绝。
So like this, we've been in the material world for many, many births.
就这样,我们在这个物质世界,很多个身世都在这个物质世界。
We have to come out of this cycle, we have to come to the transcendental platform.
我们应该脱离这个圈,怪圈之中,我们应该来到超然的层面上。We
simply act for the pleasure of Krishna.
我们一切为了Krishna而去活动。But
listen to the mind, the mind will say, enjoy. Then the mind will say, renounce. You go back and forth, on and on.
如果你只是听你的心意的享受,你的心意又说弃绝,那就是一遍又一遍的这个怪圈之中。
So the solution is not renunciation or enjoyment, but the solution is to come to devotional service.
所以真正的解决办法既不是弃绝,也不是享受,而是对Krishna的服务。Whatever
you do it for Krishna.
无论你做什么,你为了Krishna而做。It
doesn't matter what is your position in family life or not, that's not important. The important point is that you're thinking of Krishna and you're serving Krishna.
无论你在什么层面上,无论你是在家庭生活中,这些都不是重要的,你重要的是你去服务Krishna,你想着是服务Krishna。
Krishna gives you a family, Krishna gives you whatever, sometimes Krishna gives, sometimes Krishna takes, whatever situation you're in, you accept it as Krishna's mercy.
无论 Krishna 给你什么或者不给你什么，这都是 Krishna 的仁慈，你接受它，用于把它用于服务之中。
Okay.
Okay. Question no more.
No more questions?
Huh? Yes.
Okay, so thank you. Vama Ganshya Sabudhi Raike, Vama Jantai Dufani, Vama Ganshya Soida Funkshiansa, Ling Team, Tiwen, Vama Jufu Niman, Shangho Kwaila, Haho Nin Song, Vama Shivan.Dachi Rip Kwaila, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai, Hare Krishna. Thank you.
好，感谢 Gurudev 的精彩讲课，感谢 Subhiroi Prabhu 的翻译，今天的网课到这里结束了，Hare Krishna.